Hey everyone, CG here with GTO Wizard, and today I'm going to show you guys the brand new Hand History Analyzer 2.0. It's a great upgrade to an already existing tool that has helped me improve my game and my study. I'm going to show you guys the brand new features and all of the filters that have just been added that are going to make this tool take your game to the next level. Let's begin. Welcome to the Analyze section of GTO Wizard. Now, previously, the Uploads section within the Analyze tab has not changed much. However, they have changed the infrastructure into which you upload your hands so that everything is much faster. Now, when you upload your hands, you can only wait a few minutes before you get to see the results and the analyzed hands. So you can see here, I have uploaded a lot of sessions as I like to upload hands right after I play. So now that they are uploading faster, I'm able to jump right into the study while those hands are still fresh in my memory. The big upgrade from the Analyzer 2.0 is going to come in the hands section of the Analyze tab. So if we go over here, we'll see that it is a brand new UI. Although it is similar to the old one, there are a lot of new features. First off, you can now customize all of your columns. So if you look over here, there is a button called Manage Columns. And if you click that, you'll be able to see all of the different categories that you can now remove or add to the columns list. Now, previously, Wizard had a lot of these categories, like the pot size, the win loss for the big blinds, the EV loss, but there are a few that have been added. One that I'm currently using is blinds, which tells me which limit the hand took place at. And if you want to customize this, all you have to do is click the Manage Columns button, and you can come over here and look through the different list of options. So for example, if I wanted to look at the game table, I can add this right here by just clicking the green plus. And you'll see that if I scroll over to the right, it'll add my game table to the right side of the column list. And I can now filter if I wanted to look at some hands that I played for heads up. I can simply just click the top of the game table here and it'll put all of my heads up hands in a row. So really convenient when you're looking to organize a specific category within the hands section. Next to the Manage Columns button, you're going to see the Filters button. So previously, Wizard has had many filters, but now they have added a few more. If you click it, it'll bring up on the left all of the different categories that you can scroll through. You can see here we have Date, Game, Hero, Statistics, Other, or you can just choose to scroll with the All selected on the right side to see all of the different filters. Now, for us, we're going to look at the Date, and I'm going to select all of my hands in the last 3 months. So all you have to do is click the button and you'll see it come up and it'll automatically refresh all of your hands. If you look at the right side here, you'll also see a little button that pops up for remove filter. So if you didn't want to actually select that, you can just click the remove filter and it'll reset. But for now, we're going to click this last 3 months. And if we scroll down, you'll see some more filters. The status filter is new, and that's going to allow you to organize hands that are fully solved. So if you look over the little tooltip here on the question mark, you'll see that it says to use this to filter out hands that couldn't be analyzed properly. So sometimes you upload a hand and maybe it wasn't a situation that was supported by Wizard, and it'll come up as no solution. So now you can just click fully solved and that will allow you to go through all of the different hands that are fully solved. You have the hand matrix up next, and that's something that you guys are probably all familiar with. Not too much has changed here. There is a new filter here for Hero Went Post Flop. And that is going to allow you to filter for whether or not you played a hand that went to post-flop. So you can either click yes or no. Typically, I like to look at all of my decisions. So if I were to review a session, I want to see the pre-flop stuff as well. So I'm going to leave that blank. Next, you can go through your EV loss per BB, which is really cool because now you can, if you want to focus on some of the mistakes that you've played throughout the session, you can actually enter in a range that you want to look through. So if you want to look through some bigger blunders, you can put something like 5 big blinds all the way up to the max and filter out for that. You can see on the right here that there is actually a number already input, and that's going to be the highest EV loss BB that you had for the filtered hands. So it already has that kind of built-in filter if you wanted to just kind of like mess with the minimum threshold there. Scrolling down some more, you can see that there's going to be different file name filters. So if you upload a set of hands that you know you used a certain name for, you can filter for that. And then you can have a filter for your nicknames. So if you play on multiple sites and you're uploading a bunch of hands, you can actually filter through those now, which is very helpful if you only want to look at one site. You can also look at the aggression preflop. So whether or not you were the raiser or if you were the caller. So if you're looking to improve your game being the first in as the raiser, you can simply select the preflop raiser and that will also filter all of that for you. I like to look at all of the scenarios, so I'm going to keep those unchecked. And then you have the relative position, whether you were in position in the hand, out of position. Also, what position you were in. So you can filter now for whether or not you were in the button, the cutoff, the hijack, the small blind, the big blind, or under the gun. So pretty cool that they have that option. You can also filter if you play different game types. Those will now pop up under game table. So I do play some heads up occasionally. So you can see a heads up category pop up here, or I can look at my six max hands. Now going further down, you can see there is also the GTO score percentage. So again, if you want to filter for a certain score that you've gotten on the hand, you have the blind levels, which is going to be all of the different games that you play. So I play a wide variety of different blinds. I play all the way from 1-2 up to 5-10. So you can see here, if I wanted to filter through those, I could filter through those as well. If I only want to look at some of my higher stakes hands, I could just filter and click the 5-10 and the 3-6 button like this, and then go through all of my hands like that. Moving on, we have the site. So if you play on multiple sites, you can now filter for the different site and the GTO result. So this is going to be GTO Wizard's, you know, famous best move, correct move, inaccuracy, or blunder. And that actually is going to be great if you're looking for just working on your blunders, or maybe you want to, you know, share with your friends some of the best moves that you've ever made. So you can filter for that now. You also have preflop action. So preflop, limp, ISO, single raise pot, 3-bet pot, 4-bet pot, 5-bet pot, squeeze pots. So this is great for obviously indicating a very specific scenario. And then you have some EV loss for the pot percentage. You have the pot size, you have the win loss in big blinds, and the game formats and frequency difference. So the frequency difference is a higher number indicates that you're taking a low frequency line more often than maybe you should. And so if you wanted to look through that, you can filter using these parameters here. So pretty awesome update for all of the new filters just in the hand section alone. But if you also go to the stats section, the filters will be there too. After selecting our filters and organizing our columns, we can check out the stats page. Now, if you look at the top left next to the table, you'll see the stats button and it'll pull up all of our stats. These are the stats that are for the filtered hands. So if we look here, you can see that we've uploaded 7,300 hands with the specific filters that I chose previously, which were fully solved scenarios over the last 3 months. So you can see the GTO Wizard score pops up right here. We have the frequency difference percentage right here and our average EV loss next to it. If you look below, there is a new feature which allows us to filter even more. And we can filter between a few different categories. One is the street, so which street that you played or made a mistake. So you have preflop, flop, turn, and river. You have the pre-flop action. So what was the action? The position, where you were at the table. So whether you were at the under the gun position or the big blind position or the small blind position. And what was the aggression pre-flop? So whether or not you were the raiser or the caller. So this is a really cool tool to filter through to see where your mistakes are. So if you look at the street filter, you can see that pre-flop, I'm doing great. There aren't that many mistakes and there aren't that many blunders within the hands that I've uploaded. However, if we look at the river scenario, you can see that there are a lot more mistakes and blunders, even though the hand amount is a lot less. So you can see there aren't that many river situations over the hands that we've uploaded because it is more rare to get to the river. But you can see that it is maybe an early indication that as I continue to upload hands, maybe I'll see a trend that I'm making these mistakes. So this is an alert, essentially, for me to look at the river decisions I'm making closer. You can also filter for the preflop action. So if we go over to the preflop action, you can see what types of preflop scenarios I'm making mistakes in or I'm playing well in. So if you look at the single raise pots, we're doing pretty well. We're not making that many blunders. We are making a few mistakes, but we overall are playing a pretty solid game in single raise pots. Then if we look into something like a 4-bet pot, we might see an increase in my blunders. The mistakes are relatively the same, but I'm not playing as many situations perfectly. So this could be another indication that I need to work on some 4-bet pots. So you can go through all of the different types of action and look through whether or not you need some work in limped pots and ISO'd pots and squeeze pots, etc. Then you can look at your position. Again, looking at whether or not you were in the big blind, small blind, etc., and where your blunders are or where your mistakes are. Now you can see most of my mistakes are coming from the small blind and the big blind. This is no surprise to me as these are two really difficult positions to play because your range is the widest in these positions. So this is also another indication that maybe I should be working on those positions. We can then filter for the preflop aggression, looking to see if when we were the preflop raiser or the preflop caller, whether or not we were making more mistakes or playing well. And you can see that there is a difference here in me being the preflop caller and the raiser, in which I'm making more mistakes as the preflop caller. Now, again, this is another difficult position because typically when you call a raise preflop, you're going to be playing some wide positions, mostly from the big blind, but also from the button. So this is a good indication that I perhaps need to work on my blind play as the preflop caller, given that we saw the positional mistakes we were making were often in the big blind. So using these filters is a really great tool to indicate where your mistakes might be coming from. So let's put it all together to create a report about scenarios that may be causing some of my mistakes. I'm going to go over to the filter section again, and we're going to scroll down. We're going to look at some post-flop play. So I'm going to click yes for hero went post-flop. I'm also going to look at EV loss that happened. So anywhere from, let's say, one big blind all the way up to the max here, which is showing 29. And this is going to indicate that I made a mistake. Let's also filter for the pot size. So the pot size, I typically want to be looking at bigger pots. Maybe that's where a lot of my mistakes are coming from. I'm not sure, but we're going to filter some of the bigger pot sizes. So we're going to filter something like 50 big blinds all the way up to the max here, which is going to be 651. So we're going to filter for that. And then we're also going to filter for 6 max, which is where I play most of my volume. I'm going to keep the blinds unchecked because I want to be looking across all of my different stake levels. And then I also want to look at something like single raise pots. These are spots that are going to happen more often, so it's going to give me a wider range of hands. And also we want to look at preflop callers. So this is an option that we saw earlier where I was making a lot of my mistakes. Also, we want to put ourselves in the big blind because that's where, again, we were making a lot of our mistakes. So this is a very specific filter where it's going to focus a lot on being the pre-flop caller in a single raise pot from the big blind. I'm not going to filter too much for the other stuff because I want to still keep the range wide of hands that I can look at. And then we're also going to filter for blunders and wrong moves. These are two results in which it's going to show that I'm making bad plays. So all of those filters are fairly specific now to pull up some hands. And you can see there was two specific hands that the filter has found. So if we go back to a table, we'll see those two hands that I played. They were single raised pots in which we played a pot size of over 50 big blinds. And I made a mistake. So in this hand here, you can see that we defended pocket nines out of position versus a hijack open. We check, fill-in goes and bets for the large sizing, we defend. Turn, we check, and we get to the river, and we make a blunder here in which we decide to bet a large size instead of using a small size or a check. So you can see here, I made this mistake. We get raised from the hijack, and again, I make a very large blunder. So this is a good example of a spot where maybe I have a leak that I would want to further investigate and see, you know, what it is about my thought process that could have been wrong. I would do a deep dive on the scenario, and I would also think a little bit more about why was I making this call on the river after we got raised from a very strong position. So villain ended up having a good hand here. We lost the hand, but more importantly, we may have found a leak in which I was value betting too thin for a large size. So pretty cool way of using the filters to find your own leaks. Now, the cool thing is that once you've created this filter, you can also save it if you ever want to come back to it at another time. So if you go over to the report, you can click the little drop-down menu here, which allows you to manage that report. And by doing that, you can rename it to something that you want to save for later. So let's say my leaks, right? And confirm that right there. And you can see that it has changed the name and keeps it up in this tab here. So if you ever want to revisit it, you can go back into the reports tab, create new report, and you'll see down here that we have that report still saved. So pretty cool thing to save different reports where if you feel like you are having some leaks, or you wanted to show someone your game, you can make a custom report and save it for later. So now that you guys know how to navigate all of the new UI for the Hand History Analyzer, use all of the new filters, and even save your reports, you're ready to get out there and get some more hands in. It's a great tool to get better and to review your play every single day. That's what I do and what I've been doing to improve my game. There's also been some great speed improvements so that you can analyze and upload everything faster. So between all of that, there's no excuse for you to not get out there and crush it at the tables. Thanks for tuning in. Really appreciate all of the support. And I'll be here to guide you through any new features and upgrades in the near future.